Yeah. Okay, hope you are able to see my screen, right?
Yes.
Okay, so it's an interactive session. So wherever you have a doubt, you can unmute and ask your questions and go for the mute again. Okay, so it's entirely. Or if you are not feel comfortable to discuss in direct, you can use a chat window. Okay, so agenda already you know, based on the syllabus we just go and already discuss about the how the session is going to be start and what is the plan we'll be going to follow. So everything will be discussed as well as the payment details we just discussed. So few of them is joined as a trial people as well as few of them is joined for the first installment as well. Okay, so today directly we just go for the session, how it's look like, you'll get the experience as well. So as well as it's Hadoop session. I don't like to boring you. Few of them have experienced, right? So I'll raise some questions. If nobody, sorry, if anybody doesn't know what is Hadoop, the basics, you just explain what, sorry, you know, chat window. Based on that, I can raise my speed as well as I can reduce my speed as well. Okay, because here everybody will be joined, so I cannot go in fast. It's a depends on the people. If everybody know the tools very well, I don't like to boring you. The what are the important concepts are available, that speech is discussed and go for it. Okay. Yeah. Okay, fine. Then we will start from the things. So Hadoop basics, we just going to discuss. Before that, we can see how to start the installation part and all. We don't go right now because everybody is joined, right? After that, I will tell you how to install and all. Right now, we're just going to use only the run button. This is the command, you're going to use it while you're going to start all your operations. So that's it. Okay, here we will be calculated based on your computation powers, RAM, code, everything we just calculated based on that we are going to start your cluster. So my cluster will be capable to handle with the 5 node. It's a multi-node cluster we just designed with the backend support with the Docker containers. And there's some tag references I just used. Because few of them very less code and memory they will be handling. So based on that, the container will be modified. Something like we just designed it. So maximum 3 minutes, wherever you're going to start your cluster, it will be taken. After the 3 minutes, you can use your cluster as well, because all the connectivity as well, the configuration will be set up within the 3 minutes, then only it will be spinning. Okay. So somebody have knowledge, right? What is Hadoop? Just go with your knowledge. What do you feel about Hadoop? What is Hadoop? Why Hadoop is famous? Anyone?
It's a cluster computing framework.
Yeah, but we have other tools also available, right? A lot of cluster computations is available. Why Hadoop is famous? Any other tools, you know? No, it's an open source. That's a major reason. All other some cluster computing tools is available. Even IBM is using, Syncfusion is using, and some other tools also they will be using for cluster computing as well. And MPP parallel browsing also they will be followed. But Hadoop, this is completely open source. They will be produced. So that is the one of the reason for which during the 2012, it will be very famous. Okay, so in this we'll be going to discuss two layer, one is storage layer, another one is a processing layer. Okay, in storage layer, we'll be following everything with SDFS. SDFS means Hadoop Distributed File System. And processing layer, we'll be following this. Yes, please go to mute if you don't have any question.
Dinesh, sorry if I missed. Before going to what is that?
Wait. A few of them is going to mute, right? I have a question. Can you go to mute? Hello. Hello, Shivan. I couldn't make him mute. Help me mute everyone. Is it okay now? Hello?
Yes.
I'm getting still some bad voice, but everybody's in mute now.
I thought it was coming from your end.
No. It's completely silent in my area. Okay, now it's fine, I think. So processing layer, at the beginning, we just followed to go with MapReduce program. And then it completely moved with some other ecosystem integration like Spark and some test integration. A lot of things is introduced. But storage layer, nobody's can replace. They will be planned to migrate with cloud integrations. And they will be handle all the data with cloud itself nowadays. Because it's a very huge platform, the storage layer platform, so we cannot do that, any replacement. Only cloud is a big deal nowadays. So most of the company, they are interact with on-prem and cloud. Some hybrid computing, they will be following it. Okay, and MapReduce program, nobody's using much, but instead of the MapReduce program, they will be acquired with the storage layer and using a Spark developer test. This is a platform they will be introduced. Okay, inside this Hadoop, the daemons is available. So what is daemons? Daemons is nothing but the particular tool, what are the inside, they will be creating the services, right? Some supporting services, everything they will be calling as a daemons. So like name node, data node, secondary name node, and yarn. Node manager. Okay, before resource manager. As well as job tracker. Here it is a task tracker. And what else? Yeah, important. Okay, these are all the base layers is available. So everything we can visually see that. Okay, so this is ready. Mute everyone. Okay, fine. So now I just go here and check. This is the 8 port. Here, this is the application, Yarn application management. Here, we can see all the information, like how the application is working, how the name node, how many active name node is working, all the information. This is the Yarn platform. If you want to know your Hadoop, then you can use this port number. Okay, this is Hadoop information. How many data node you'll be using. I will tell you what is data node in detail, just giving you some overview references. So here, the configuration capacity, how much you are going to use it, and any data node is available, and how many live node is running on, all the information you can get from here as well. Okay, so total capacity 1.23, based on your system capacity, it will be raising it. And all the information you can handle with your data. There is no restrictions based on your inputs. Depends on your core as well as the RAM, right? Based on that, you can use any kind of inputs. Even 50 GB data you want to process it, then our cluster will be supported. So you don't worry about that. Your input size while processing your data with our platforms. That's the major reason we just plan to integrate it. Okay. Now, in name node, what is the use of that? Name node and data node, both of them is a kind of machine spawning. Okay, we'll be going to connect multiple nodes, right? Let me use some paints. Okay, so let's suppose you're going to handle with your multi-node cluster with the Hadoop framework layer, and you're going to install multiple nodes here. One node is going to be act as a name node, that is a master node. It has only control all other data nodes. It's just providing only the command, all other data nodes just responding back. That's it. Data node 1, data node 2, data node 3, data node 4, and something like that. So this is the way the cluster will be designed. So whenever the request comes, as I am a client, I'm going to raise any request to the name node. The name node can recognize, and it will be internally following some YARN architecture to allocate the resources and all. Based on the YARN architecture, resource manager is a kind of one more services available that is going to be create a job and monitor. From here only, all your node will be handled. If suppose you have 100 GB of data, you want to process it with your Hadoop cluster. So you know your 100 GB of data. This data will be requested to your name node. I want to process this much of that data. Then name node can decide 100 GB. Then I have to allocate 100 GB based on the resources. Then it will be informed to YARN. YARN just verify with how many nodes available, how much availability, total cores and RAMs, everything is available. That will be calculated based on your YARN and create a job. If the resources are available, then YARN can confirm and inform to the resource manager. Okay, you can allocate this much resources for this particular task, something like that. Resource manager going to create a job number. Like application ID, it is going to be create and provide some informations. Based on the application ID only, all the data node is going to be responded. But inside the data node, we will be creating another one daemon is called node managers. Each data node, we will be going to install node managers. This node manager only control all the tasks. Example, I'm saying 100 GB data is employee data. And 10 GB data I'm going to process with some accounts data. This two data I'm going to I will make some queries and provide these queries to name node. So I want to read the data for employee as well as accounts. Both data I want to read and do some operations. Here, the application ID, just a query is going to be executed. Based on the query, it will be create only one job number. While it's going to be executed each data node, it will be following some task numbers. Here, some task number will be generated, task number one, task number two, task number three, and task number four. So based on the task only, the mapper and reducer part is going to be work. Okay, these are the basic references. Any question in this?
So you're trying to select something from employee and account. So whether the database residing inside this master and node concept or database residing outside of
no master doesn't have any other data information.
Okay,
only it have metadata information, that's it. Okay, it can maintain the metadata information. What kind of data it is? Suppose this 100 GB, right? So because it's a file storage only, so different file format I can use it. In this file format, I can use as a ORC file format. In this file format, I can use as a Parquet. These are all the famous file format in Hadoop platform. So this ORC file format as well as the Parquet file format, this data is stored across all your node. I will tell you the block size and all later. Those basic references. So in this ORC file format as well as the Parquet file format, information only stored in name node. like 100 GB data. Based on that, it will be split into 100 partitions. It will be go with 800 partitions will come, I think. 800 partitions of data is going to be loaded into inside your data room across all your data room, not only the single data room. Because it's a multi-node cluster, each node has some limited capability. So data node 1 have 200, data node 2 have 300, data node 3 have 100, data node 4, 200. So this kind of data partitions only happen, and it will be split across all your nodes. And this information only is going to be stored in main node, where the data is loaded. Total 800 is for this 100 GB data, 200 in data node 1, 300 in data node 2, 100 in data node 3, and 200 in data node 4, as well as the replication factor. This is also one of the concepts available. While storing the data for this 200 partition, it will be replicated to other nodes. Okay, so data node 1, based on the number of replications, data replication 2 or 3, whatever, based on that, the data is going to be stored here as per here. Because in case of any fault that happened with this particular data node, we cannot get the data. We may be losing. So some rack awareness concept, they will be using some internal algorithm and split it here. Okay, guys, my voice is okay or very low? Still.
Okay, yeah, okay. Based on, we're trying to store 100 GB of employee data into a master and master and child node concept.
Master node doesn't store any your actual data, just to store the metadata.
Right.
Metadata. Yeah, that's it.
Okay. So actually, where does that initial 100 GB of data residing? Whether it is in database or where it is?
No, it's a storage path only. Like your system laptop, you have storage, right? SSD hard disk, normal hard disk drive.
Okay, any form of physical storage. Okay.
Yeah, exactly. It's a kind of framework. Hadoop is a kind of framework, that's it. It's a kind of software, visual framework. Okay, beyond that, nothing. Just showing you. I'm going to use this right now. I just installed that Hadoop framework in my system. If suppose I'm going to stop my Hadoop cluster and start it again, I may be losing all these informations. Because always it should be running. It's because based on the Hadoop framework only, software only, it's going to be recognized all the information. In real time, all the nodes should be followed with high availability basis. You know, I hope, right? That high availability. So always will mean our data is available, the node will be keep on balancing your data. That's high availability. In case of any failures happen, another node will be start and monitor all your data to avoid the business continuity, business failures. So basically interactions, most of the company will be using high availability concept only in the back. Same here also.
I'm not getting the high availability point, Dinesh.
High availability. Okay, so it's nothing but it will be following, you're going to be using the nodes, right? Multiple nodes. So in this data node is going to be down or failure, any upgrade you are going to do that. At the time you cannot handle your data, right? That's a common business use case. You may be failure, some server downs before it was happened. Nowadays it's nothing like that because always data will be communicated. No downtime nowadays, you will be not facing that much. In previous 5 years back, you may be facing the entire 1 day or 3 days, the system goes down and then only it will be refreshed. So this kind of problem nowadays, it won't come. The reason behind, they will be following with high availability. Because one node goes down, the same data will be followed and monitored with other nodes. And it will be take the charge and monitor. Even for your database server, Oracle or MS SQL server, there also they introduced high availability concept to balancing your data.
Okay. Got it. It all happens automatically, right? Based on the master.
Yeah. It has, it always will be synced together. Whenever one node is down, immediately it can recognize and will be take the responsibility and inform to your admin team master. Admin team will come and monitor what kind of error it is based on the logs and they will be resolved. Okay.
Yeah,
Dinesh,
thanks.
Dinesh, I have one doubt.
Yeah, please.
Suppose we are going to process 1 TB data. This data node will convert. Suppose four data nodes are available.
Yeah.
This 1 TB data will convert into 4 DB data.
Yes, based on the replications. If supposed to mention four replications, then it will be it has to store as a 4x.
So this case is store more storage space record, right?
Yeah. In Hadoop 2x, that's one of the problem. That will be overcome with Hadoop 3x, but they are also using some storage spaces more, but it will be reduced. So this is the first session. I didn't go in depth in that, what it is each one of them is doing. I just giving the overview, what the daemon, what it is doing, something like. We will discuss the replication factor and Erasure encoding concept, something they have introduced in Hadoop 3x. Each daemon we are going to discuss, right? I will give you that information as well. Then. Okay.
One more doubt.
Yeah.
This 1 TB data, we want to move into Hadoop system or directly, suppose we are having backup, we can directly access data.
No, you have to move into your Hadoop framework, right? Then only the name node can understand.
Okay.
And your normal system partitions, that block size, everything is very less. For your Windows platform, they will be following just 128 KB of block sizes only. In Linux platform, they are following maximum 4 KB. Beyond that, nothing. So if as you advised, you are going to process with 1 TB of data. 1 TB of data, if you are going to create multiple minimum size of partition, then it will be taking more time, right? Because it will be creating multiple partitions. So that's the reason the default block size they will be designed. Because based on the block size model, the partition is going to be using. So default block size has 128 MB in Hadoop 2x version, they will be introduced. And still they will be following the same things only for Hadoop 3x as well. Because based on the block sizes only, it's going to be handled. Okay. While we are going to discuss about this storage layer in detail, as well as how the map reduce is going to be processed, I will tell you how the block size will be introduced and how input split will be picked from that. All the details, step by step. Okay. So right now we just discuss only what is name node, data node, yarn, resource manager, node manager. That's it. Any question on this?
So this 100 GB of data is stored in storage layer, right? HDFS?
Yeah. Okay. Exactly. All other data nodes, right? That only residing your 100 GB of data. Not in name node. Name node just to have only one information. Can I clear this one? Sorry for my worst handwriting, but I'm trying to give some information about this. Can I clear this?
Yes.
Okay. So let's take the example. I just take the same example. You have five node cluster, one as a master, another one as a another four as a slave. So 100 GB of data, you're going to store it. This data is going to store here. Already I informed, this is a name node. These are all the data nodes. 3, 4. Okay. So how the data stored? As I advised here, 200 partition, 300 partition, 100, 200. This kind of partition data will be stored here. What name node will be belongs to store that information? So this data, I have mentioned some name, file name, right? So let me consider this file name as abc.txt. Okay, for example, txt, text format, I just take it out. So abc.txt, this is the file name, 100 GB of data, in which store it. Name node can consider this data, abc.txt. Okay, this is a file name. This file is 200 data is going to be stored in data node 1. 300 partitions of data will be stored in data node 2. 100 partitions of data stored in data node 3. As well as 200 partitions of data will be stored in data node 4. As well as this replication is stored with another data node. 2, comma data node for randomly, I just provide this information. Same like 300, right? 300 partitions of data is mainly presenting with data node 2, and other data will be stored in data node 3 and data node 1.
White has split it into 800 GB of data.
1 GB will almost will be split into 8 partition maximum. So 100 GB will be 800. I will tell you the calculations while starting before with the Spark and all, right? We'll be discussing this in detail. But it should be in 800 or around, I'm sure. Okay. And based on the splittable also, splittable is a kind of concept is available. That is also we'll go in detail.
So each node, each data node will be having the complete 100 GB of data, right? Or
No, that's the reason it will be split into partition. Even your Windows also, you are going to store your data, right? You are going to store your 1 MB of files. You are going to take a picture, that picture size is 1 MB. Let me take it out. This images, right? The JPG file. It's look like 1 MB in front of you. But in the back end, it will be using multiple partitions based on the 128 KB sizes. So there is a lot of 128 KB of blocks will be created in the back end. All this data will be combined, then only it will be showing us 1 MB. Okay, like that the blocks and partitions will be split internally, but you will not be seeing that information. Okay, you're getting my point?
Yeah, got it. It's look like a memory blocks.
MLOC and say a lock, something will come, right? So based on the blocks only, it will be moved into the RAM and process it.
If I lose one data node, how will I retrieve the data from other partitions? Is there a chance for that? If I lose data one node, so how will I retrieve the data?
That's the reason the data will be stored in data node 3 and 4, right? From there, it just picks up that information.
Okay, right.
Okay. Simple example I can give you, your mobile phone. Okay. In mobile phone, you are going to use only 2 GB or 4 GB of RAM, only maximum you're going to use it. Right. But you are going to see the videos and all. You are going to play something, right? All the operation will be running at the same places. Multiple application will be using at the same time. Everything will be handled only with your 2 GB of RAM. So in the back end, it will be sent based on the serialized data with your partitions, blocks only. Same like here. It's look like your total size of 1 MB or 1 GB or 10 GB. The back end, it just process based on the blocks only. Okay? This is the way it's happening. Same here also, you can consider it. Any question?
Dinesh, if it is in a HDF, if it is in a Hadoop, it's a mandatory to bring the data into HDFS, then only it will be start the processing, or we can able to connect with the respective data source and we will start the processing.
You have to move your data to Hadoop platform, then only you can handle with your processing layer. If suppose you're going to store your data with your local, you cannot interact with other nodes. Okay, because these are the four node, right? Everything you can as a edge node and you can connect it. That's not a problem. But it will be keep that your data in, okay, in your local, it will be communicated only to this particular data node. All other data node will not be communicated with this data. But you are move the data into Hadoop framework, everything will be synced together. Okay, this is the difference. Virtually, you just create a wrapper framework. Inside the wrapper framework, the data is going to be stored based on the different partition sizes, and it will be monitored by your name node, and it will be keep on telling. That is happening. Got it? Any question? Are you clear or confused?
Understood.
If okay, fine. So now you have some idea what is name node. right? Named node holds metadata information. You can nowadays in an interview, they will not be asked more about name node, data node in detail. They will be just asked about the basic references. So data node only having the physical, actual physical data. And secondary name node. This is also one of the name nodes available. Secondary name node is nothing but this is the backup for your primary name node. Because you know very well the data node goes down, then you have replication data, you can handle it. What if primary name node goes down? You cannot handle it, right? Because here only all the requests will be reached. So name node goes down, you cannot continue your operations. One, TN2, TN3. Okay. In Hadoop 1x, what they have done, they are also following some name node with the backup, which is called as a secondary name node. But they will not be raising high availability inside. Okay, here only the high availability comes. So based on the name node, based on the name node, the cluster, entire cluster will be responding continuously. If name node goes down, we cannot continue our business until it will be stopped. Again, as a 1x, Hadoop 1x, that manually the people are going to start that secondary name node, then only they will be following all your data operations. That's happening. But Hadoop 2x and 3x, automatically high availability, they will be introduced in standby name, secondary name node with the two concepts called standby name node, as well as standby name node. I cannot remember. I will tell you. Okay. So based on the standby name node only, they will be going to create active node. Active node as well as the passive nodes. So standby name node, if you have a huge cluster, you want to keep on monitor data without any losses, there only they will be using standby name node. Otherwise, they will be just enable the secondary name node, and whenever it's required, it's started. Standby name node additional works, additional responsibility to split that task as well as with your name node, actual name node. Because all the request name node will not be taking over that. So standby name node also will be taking the responsibility and share their operation, all the tasks. Something like they will be designing. This is only available in SDFS 2x version. SDFS 2x greater than all the versions that will be introduced. Hadoop 1x format, they don't have this operations. SDFS, Hadoop, both are same only. By just mentioning SDFS are common. Okay. You're getting right? The high availability where it comes. Because name node only have this information. Let's take this one. 100 GB of data, abc.txt. This information is wherever the data will be split and stored into the multiple data node. Name node have this information. If suppose name node goes down, we don't know what kind of data will be stored inside to your data node. That information only we can gather from your name node. But the data will be holds here, but we don't have that information. It's kind of raw data. We cannot handle anything with that. We must know what kind of data it is. We must know what kind of serialization format they will be used. It's a single one data I'm saying. And the GB is abc.txt. You'll be using 10,000 files, same like that. Everything will be keep on residing with your data nodes from all the information you'll be collecting from name node. So name node goes down, you cannot continue. Okay, that's the reason secondary name node come to the picture. Clear guys? Any question?
After secondary node, what is it? SBNN?
Standby name node.
Standby. So it is the, it will come next to secondary node.
Inside the, instead of the secondary name node, they will be using as a standby name node. If you are going to use a more than 100 node cluster, okay, secondary name node will not be capable. So standby name node, they will be act as a secondary name node. Inside the standby name node, will be following active node and passive nodes. This is a shareable with your all the tasks. Because you have a 5,000 node cluster you're going to create, 10,000 node cluster you're going to create. Based on the business use case, you can expand your cluster sizes. Then you want to share all your operation, right? Single node will not be taking this kind of operation, right? So then only it will come to this picture. If less than 100 node cluster, they will be using only the secondary node as a standby node. Okay.
Until there is a problem, system will not go after 9 node, right?
Mm.
Okay. So is there anything like ANPN for 9 node itself? Name node itself?
Name node is a base, right? So name node will take and have following all these operations.
Okay.
Okay. So another name for standby name node is called backup nodes. It will be keep on backup, right? So this is called as a backup node as well. Basically. And another one, yeah, I can remember checkpoint node. CKPM node. If suppose very less size of cluster, they'll be following this checkpoint node. If huge cluster you're going to use it, then they'll be creating standby name node, they'll be following it. These are also admin part, mostly. Okay, you don't worry about it, but for the references, I'm saying this around. How it is working.
How name node and secondary name node are communicating?
Yeah, that's called heartbeat. Okay. This is the pulse. Some pulses will be sending. I will tell you something. I will go with some step by step, right? I will be mentioning this one. Name node and data node also will be communicated. This is also available. I will tell you. Or let me mention all the daemons first and then we can discuss. We can clear. That would be better, I think so. What are the other keywords or terms they are using? Everything we can mention here and we can discuss that. Name node, data node, secondary name node, yarn, resource manager, node manager, data over, block size, input split, replication, block size, input split, replication. Heartbeat. What else? Block repo. Block report. It was split, I mentioned that. Application heartbeat block report. What else? Edit log. Zookeeper. What else? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. At least 3 should go. Zookeeper. Block size, block report for the data processing this one. Application. FS images. I think that's it. SDFS federations. Input split. Okay. So these are the basics, key terms they are using while they are going to discuss about Hadoop platforms. Okay, these are also daemons. This is also internal key terms they are going to use it. Here, whatever you are asking, right? So let's, this one, high availability also, right? High availability, how it is working. So name node we know very well. Second data node we know. Secondary node we know very well. inside the secondary name node, standby name node is available. Standby name node, they'll be following the active node as well as a passive node. Okay, this one will come to this and checkpoint node as well as a backup node. This four we have discussed. These are also admin part. We don't want to go in detail that. Next, yarn. Yarn is nothing but yet another resource negotiator. So it's just negotiate how much resource I we have to allocate for the particular task. Whenever the request comes from name node to given yarn. Okay, yarn only can confirm based on the resources. Sorry, based on the resources, it will be allocated to resource manager. Resource manager creating job as per yarn request. Okay, without yarn confirmation, resource manager will not be started. Just creating a job for your query. That will be considered as one job number. That's it. Inside the query, it's going to be handled multiple data, multiple tasks. That will be handled by your node manager. Node manager is available each data node. Okay, and handling the multiple tasks as per resource manager job. Okay, if that particular task is over, then only it will be start and monitor all your operations. Even a single task is failure, you cannot continue it. Okay, all the tasks should be completed. Multiple. Even a single task is failure, you cannot complete. They'll be using reattempt task. Some concept is available. If suppose one particular task is not able to handle with your data node one, it has to start and communicate with data node because some data will be replicated other nodes as well, right? So that particular task will be reattempt on data node three or four and will be running it. Or they will be enable the parallelism. The same task will be running on other data nodes as well. You are going to handle with, let's take this 100 GB itself. This 100 GB of data abc.txt, you're going to handle with 800 partitions, right? Let me consider this is as a 800 task we have created. So 750 task is over. It's done successfully without any problem. It's done. 50 task have some trouble. There you can mention some retry attempts. So this 50 task will be split. Okay, I don't go in depth. I just mentioned 795 is over, just to 5 we can take. Is over, 5 tasks only is not completed yet. So data node 1, 3 tasks have pending, and data node 2 has to complete 2 tasks. So this is same task, sorry, this is the same data available other nodes, right? This task is going to be start and spin up with other data nodes as well. Wherever which one is completed first, based on that input, it will be combined with your 795 task outputs and providing us a final outcome. That is called as parallelisms. Okay, so this based on this parallelism, they are using speculative execution concept. Speculative execution. Okay. So same operation will be happen other data node itself, but based on the outcomes, other two jobs will be killed, the particular other two tasks will be killed, the particular task which one is providing the first output, it will be combined and will be providing the final outcome. Okay, that is comes under speculative execution concepts. Okay. Any question till now, node managers? While we are going to work with Hive and all, right, there I will try to show you all this mapper and Redis how it is working. Any question? Node manager, resource manager, still no.
Dinesh, will you be sharing any notes, something like that, after the post session to have a reference, something like that?
In a material window, we will be having a lot of e-books available for your references.
Okay. Why? Because too much of concepts, right?
That's what I just folded. I don't like to go in depth. Till now, if you have doubts in this, you can ask me. We will discuss this again. So, don't worry about it. I don't like to go in everything at the same day, but you'll be raising a lot of questions, right? So that I just bring up all the keywords first. But even though it's fine, we will be discussing this point. You're not clear, or you're not comfortable with this any particular the daemons or key terms, you just let me know. We'll discuss that again. Just we can consider 3, 4, 5, 6 points.
Daemon is basically sorry, go ahead.
Yeah, sorry. How Yarn is actually interacting with all those things?
Okay, I will tell you. This is Yarn. Okay, Yarn, you can see with this node number, localhost, time, age, right? So 88, right? Here only you can see your Yarn information. So actually, I informed yet another resource negotiator. It only have all the information, right? So total you can consider here. Let me save this and clear it. Okay. So I just mentioned final cluster. I'm going to use it. This file active node. These are the node name. These are the node address, and these are the HTTP address I'm using. Each node I just pin up with 4 GB of RAM and 2 core. Right. So total how much it is? How many data will be running in the back? Total 5, right?
Yes.
Your cluster size is 5, correct?
Mm-hmm.
So total 2, 4, it's 20 GB of memory as well as 10 core is available. Am I right?
Right.
Here you can see this information. Total resources, 20 GB memory, 10 cores. This is available. No used resources tip. We will not be used anything because we just spin up our cluster. Let me go and start Hadoop. Okay, let me try to start Hive example. I'm going to allocate some process with this Hive right now. Create database DE25. Use DE25. Create table D1. ID as integer. Okay, this is a dummy only. This is fine. Insert into D1 ID values something like I just try to insert now. MapReduce job has started. The query window will be created right now. Let me go here. Just I'm going to application. Now you can see this one. This is will be allocated with the 2 core right now and 1 GB of RAM. So total out of 20 GB as well as the 10 core, it just used 2 cores as well as almost 2 GB of RAM for this particular task. This task is a MapReduce task and it will be following the dev queue. Later point with the queues and that we will be discussed, but now you can understand. The resource Yarn will be provided for this particular task. We can allocate 2 core maximum as well as this much of GB of RAM for this. And this is running state now. Now data is inserted, right? select star from T1. I can see the data. Job is completed. It's a finished state. Again, your resource has been released. Total 20 GB is back available. 10 courses available now. So based on your request, this query, you are just passing the query. Select star from our insert into. These are the query. You just pause it, right? This Hive is going to communicate with your Hadoop cluster. Okay. You are passing your query in Hive. In the backend, you are passing the query, right? This query is going to be reached into name node. Name node can pick this query and provide into Yarn. Yarn just recognized how much what is the query they'll be using, how much they'll be using the backend with that particular inputs and all. If this is nothing beyond it, just they are trying to insert one particular record into or Hadoop platform. So NameNode can consider and it will be allocated almost 2 GB of RAM to code. This information will be picked and the resource manager can allocate the job number. Job number, you can see this one. This is the applications, right? So number. This is your job number. Some job ID just generated. Some application ID. This is some 001, something is available. This ID has to be generated. This resource manager, once it is generated, it is assigned to your nodes. So here only node manager can take this responsibility with multiple tasks. Okay, so 001, it's almost 2 GB, 2 core only. So it will be going to assign any one of the node manager only, I think so. Because there is no much data partitions. It is assigning to a particular node and store it. If I am going to see this information in detail, let me open it. You can see this information. Attempt ID. Okay, here it is assigned for this particular node. This is the node information. So this is assigned to this only one node and continue all your operations as well. And suppose your data is huge and you need to communicate with multiple nodes. Here, that attempt ID will create multiple attempt ID numbers and multiple nodes will be communicated together. This information you can see here. Now you are visually compare it, right? How Hadoop is working. Any question in this?
what is course?
Core, your processor. You're going to use it Hi-5 processor, you're going to use it i7 processor, right? Inside the processor, they will be using dual, 4-core, octa-core, or dual-core, something they will be coated dual. Before coming to your i3, i5, it is called as a coated dual, right? Coated dual, dual-core, some processor is available, which means right. It have that much core only.
Something related to processing.
Yes, your processor. In Windows, they will be calling us a processor. In Linux platform, they will be mentioning as a vCPU or core. Hadoop completely running on Linux platforms.
So, as a developer, we don't have much in core. Right?
We don't.
Also, just to make my understanding right, like. You have created a data table in a database using Hive, and then you have inserted, and then you have selected the inserted record. 3 database action you did from Hive, right? So my understanding, like only on selection part, Hadoop application is involved. Is that right?
Sorry, some places I have network trouble. Few I cannot get it. Question in detail. Can you give me 1 second?
Am I audible now?
Yeah, you're clear. I have some.
I'll ask.
Not working before.
Okay, just to make sure my understanding is right. With respect to Hive, you created a database, you created a table, you have inserted a record, and then you have selected almost like 4 actions, right, on a on Hive. Exactly. So, whether all those four actions is it's having some relationship with the Hadoop application.
Yes.
Whether job ID will be available for all those four actions or only on selection part, I mean, select star from the table, for that alone job will be created.
Not like that, okay? Few of them, internal core will be handle it. Internal is the particular node itself. I will tell you in some time. Till now, everyone is clear, right? No question. I want to confirm that first before going to discuss that. Till now, any question? I just submit a Hive query. I just going to see in Yarn how it, that resource will be allocated based on the resources, how the resource manager will be created, the job, and the particular job, we can see how many node will be allocated for the task. This is all we can virtually see right just before. Any question in this? I will tell you the back end, what is happening.
Okay. I have one question here, actually. It's a simple select. Consider we are selecting 10 rows, and Hadoop is, based on your example, whether Hadoop will generate more partitioning for a very simple select also, or it will apply for only one data node?
It depends on your scenario. I will tell you next.
Okay.
Till now, no question. Let me discuss that.
If Yarn requires more resources, means it will allocate another data node also, right?
If it is not capable with the particular node, then resource Yarn will be allocated other node as well. Because each of them will be considered 2 core 4 GB RAM, right?
Yes.
Each node have. So until that it will be available, Yarn can consider, because all the nodes right now will not use it. Entire resources free. So immediately Yarn can consider and allocate one node itself. Or if it will, multiple queries will be passing in runtime, it will be allocated multiple nodes at the same time.
Okay, thanks.
Okay, so based on the IDLs as well as your node capacity, based on it will be modified. That will come to capacity discussion, shared node part.
Okay.
Okay, we will discuss that in detail. Any question? Any other question? Okay, fine. Okay, I will tell you your answer. Okay, let me take this moment. So, Hive query, I just pause it. Select start from. At the time, it won't take any operations. You can see this one. Select star from here only. I just pause it, right? Okay. So here, select star from this query. I just pause it. It just picked the data. At the time, it is going to be interact with your node and take your local cores. Each of your data node as well as main node have local cores. And then it will be allocated for Hadoop. It will be split one for operating system, another one for even Hadoop framework. So it's a very less operation, minimal operation, mostly trying to avoid the map reduce concept, because it takes long time and complete this kind of task. So minimal operations, mostly Hadoop as well as your main node will prefer and suggest with your local node itself. It just communicate and read the data. Okay, so automatically convert and run it. In case you are going to do some different process, like a count, you are going to do that, or any aggregation you are trying to do that. At the time, we don't have any other option, then automatically it will be considered and run your MapReduce program and pick your data. This is happening. And in the back end, whatever you will be discussed, right? Where the data is actually located. While you're going to create the table, create the databases, everything in the front view in Hive, you can pass a query, but actual data is going to be stored inside of your data nodes. It have multiple data nodes, right? Okay, so Hive query, you're just passing create table and insert some data. This is belongs to going to store in any one of your data nodes. Whether it is a data node 1, 2, or 3, any places it's going to be stored that actual data. It will not be in local. So based on your query inputs, it will be stored here. And based on your query inputs, it will be retrieved. This concept is called as a SERDI. Okay, this is we'll be discuss in detail while we are going to discuss about Hive. Just information, I just provide this basics. Okay, now this data we know very well. This data is going to store here only and retrieved from here. So MapReduce is going to be executed once yarn is confirmed. In case nameNode will not be reached into yarn properly, it will not be start the MapReduce program. It's just waiting for accepted state. While whenever you're going to submit a job from nameNode to yarn, three stages is available. One is accepted. Okay. Running. Second state, running. Third state, success or fail. Okay, these two is in the same state. It should be a success or failure state. Okay, this four stages one is available. Whenever job submitted, even the yarn don't have that much capable RAM or code, and it will be wait for some resources until this is in accepted state, which means nameNode will provide the query information. Yarn accept that and keep on waiting. It will not be start to process it in. Once the particular resource is available, and then yarn can confirm and it will be moved into running state, which means it can assign the RAM, code, everything and create a resource manager job, right? If the job is going to be start here only. So even if it is in accepted state, your job is not started, just it is keep on waiting. While it's moved into running state, then it will be your resource manager start your process operations. At the last, the query, everything is properly fine. As far as your cluster is everything fine, it's going to be success. In case of any query wrong, you will be providing some query, right? Select start from table. Instead of select from start table, something you may be provided. The query is wrong, it's trying to run it and syntax error, something's happened, it just recognized and it will be failed. So this kind of states only comes. Let me go and run the job with the suggest count operation in Hive, then we can compare it again. Just the same table, I'm going to take it up. Okay, just to count, I have only one record. I'm trying to count it again. Oh, sorry. This is also very less, and then it will be considered with your note. I have only ID column, right? What is it? Distinct? Let me try. Yeah. And now I'm trying with the distinct operation. Here you can see this one, the job has to be created. Particular job number has to be generated. If this is the tracking URL, you can track that we have seen just before with yarn detail, right? That information you can get from here only. There's a job number. Even if suppose you want to kill this job, you can kill it. Okay, and then MapReduce program, I just started. This states we will see while we are going to work with Spark and all, right? I will show you that. All the state information detail. Okay, here mapper and reducer is just started. Mapper 100% task is completed and reducer part is running in the back. Okay, everything is over. Mapper 100%, reducer also 100%. That CPU cumulative seconds is taken out, almost 2.42 seconds maximum. And the job has completed. So maximum 2 seconds, 420 milliseconds time was taken and pick the data. You can see the particular job number 002. Yeah, there's a job number, right? Starting job 002. This information's you can see in yarn as well. 002 MapReduce operation and just started. Okay, this is the way it is communicated and sharing your operations. We're going to handle with some huge data later. There we can see how is real-time experienced. Okay, while we are going to discuss about projects and all, right? that I will show you in detail more. Okay. Any question?
What is a, can you give an example on how, what is a mapper and reduce? What is the purpose of it?
Yeah, I will. Mapper and reduce is a processing layer. We will not be touch up still. I will add that okay. Also. Okay. I want to understand everyone. That's it. Okay. If you have any question, whatever we have discussed, we will go in detail. Later, I will tell you this.
Yeah, got it. Sure. Mm-hmm.
The mapper and reducer mostly we will be discussing a little bit high operations, but I will give you some inputs. Okay, any question, guys?
We have created a database and inserted data into any of the data nodes, right? When we are going with the select statement, how the name node knows which data node need to process?
Okay, good question. Okay, let me show you where the data is actually in. You just execute the tables and all, right? So you just run it. You have to use the describe formatted table name. You can get all the information, what kind of data it is, how it is going to store, all the information you can collect from here. You just noticed this is the location, this is the Hive location, so Hadoop location. In this location only, the data is going to be stored. Just copy the informations. Let me go and open a new one. Okay, this is a separate container. This all you going to handle with your Jupyter lab. I'm trying to create all the terminals there itself. Now also it just created. Let it. Oh, sorry. I just created a separate container. Okay, here all your code you can save and you can reuse it. That is the reason I just created this kind of lab here. Can open, let me check. Okay, the data is actually stored. This is the format. We just create simple table. It's a text file format only just created. Okay, but you can see this. Let me change the theme into dark. Font size. Okay, hope you are able to see in detail, right? Okay, so I can, this is the data is actually 0000, right? This is actual data. This is the path directory in Hadoop. I just copy that. This is DFS-CAC. We will discuss Hadoop comments later, but for your reference, I'm doing right now. So now you can see your actual data. You just insert one as a record, right? That record is stored into this one. Now let me try to insert one more record. To T1 IDS 2. I'm trying to insert now. Let me run the code. Sorry. This path, I just run the code again. Now you can see some of the new data will be created. Okay. Inside the path, let me go into execute. This command, cat command. _COP1 something, right? Now you can see the second account. If I want to retrieve all the data, I can mention simple star. Then you can see the data, 1 and 2. Let me go and insert a new record again. So this is 3. This is 4. Some new record I just inserted here, right? Okay, now I just go here. First, select star from T1. 1, 2, 3, 4 records is available. Now I'm going to list the data inside the directory. 1, 2, 3, 4. All the record will be stored here. Now I'm going to read the data using cat command. 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's look like you're passing a query insert statement, but it is creating a file and store it to Hadoop environment. This is the way the communication happens inside and process it. Okay. So Hive query is a front-end layer. While it's executing the MapReduce, it's just trying to load the data into your Hadoop platform. Okay? Are you able to understand how Hadoop is working, how Hive is working, the basics?
Hive is a kind of front-end editor, and storage will be happen on the Hadoop side.
Exactly. Hive is not a front-end editor. It is called as an ecosystem tools of Hadoop.
Okay.
So in interview, they will ask ecosystem. What is ecosystems? What is ecosystem? What is the meaning for ecosystem? Why solar is ecosystem?
It will have a circle from start to end.
No, it depends with the sun. Solar is the sun, right? So without sun, other plants will not be born. So it merges and depends with solar sun only. That's the reason we are calling this a solar ecosystem, like that Hadoop ecosystem. Without Hadoop, Hive will not be work properly. Okay, so Hadoop is a kind of, Hive is a kind of ecosystem of Hadoop. Not only Hadoop, sorry, Hive. You have other tools as well. Flume is there, Scope before it was there, MapReduce program integration. Most of the tools are part of ecosystem of Hadoop. Now only they are interacting and move with the other environment. Okay. Before, at the beginning, Spark was a kind of ecosystem. Later they have realized and they will be creating without Hadoop as well. But still they have compatibility with Hadoop. Some library jars they will be using the backend for the communication layers. Okay.
Okay, got it.
Are you clear now? Okay, fine. Block size, input split. This all we have to go with command, Hadoop commands. There only we can get this information in detail. No, it's not. We will not be discussing that. We will complete the theory part today. Tomorrow we will go with commands, Hadoop commands and all. So let me go with replication. So SDFS 2x version, they are following common 3x replications, which means replica by 3. You're supposed to store your data, 1 GB of data, you're going to store it in Hadoop platform. So you have data node, right? Multiple data nodes, you're going to use it. On one master node, you're going to process it. While you're storing the data into Hadoop environment, HDFS2 expression, it just recognized and input can get the information. Let's take 1 GB of data, I'm going to store it. name node can get this information. One GPS XYZ dot txt. The file is currently stored. Name node know very well and just trying to store into data node 1, data node 2, or data node 3, something like it just decided. So first name node is going to store into data node 2 itself. First data, the actual copy of the data will be stored into data node 2. Once data properly stored, then from here by 3x replication, right? One copy available here, another one copy will move any one of random your data nodes, even data node 1, 3, 4, but it will not be replicated on same data node. It should be replicated to other data node. This is the way they will be designed. This concept is called intra data node concept. Intra data node block scanners. Okay, it just calculate and validate the same node will be same data will be replicated in same data node or not, something like. And it will not be alone mostly. If suppose it's available the same data here in data node 2 itself, it will be try to delete it and create the replication with other data nodes. The reason again, if data node 2 goes down, we have to pick the data from other data nodes. That's the reason replication will come with the 3x. But the drawback is it's supposed to store 1 GB of data, it will be in a 2x replication spinning. So total 3 GB of data, you're going to spend it. This is the drawback, they will face it. But even though it's fine, the most of the companies still, they are using 2x funding. They will not be moving to Hadoop 3x still. Okay. Are you clear with replication? Even top management, top MNCs also, they are using Hadoop 2x funding. They will not be moved into 3x. On few of the companies, they are moving to 3x. Any question till now? Okay, hope no question then. Okay, let me consider no question. In Hadoop 3x, they are trying to overcome with Azure encoding as a kind of concept. Okay, based on the Azure encoding, they are trying to avoid this much of space storages. So inside, they are following some concept, Azure encoding, RS code. RS code and XOR gate algorithm. And third one, RS code XOR gate parity block. Okay, this is the concept they have introduced in Hadoop 3x. This is an actual old concept which it will be used for your engineering and most of the engineering platform, they will be using this concept. Okay, what they are trying to do with this Azure encoding. Okay, so name node. I'm doing a bit fast for sign and all because I don't like to waste your time while taking the decisions. So if suppose 1 GB of data, I'm going to store xyz.txt inside to name node. Okay, so sorry, inside to Hadoop cluster, name node can pick this information and try to store this data in any one of the node as advised before with the Hadoop 2x. So first data will be replicated from here to the data node 2. 1, data node 2, data node 3. This data first, it just come to the data node 1. Immediately, data node 1 will not be duplicated to other data nodes with the 3x. Here it is creating some parities. Like between this node and this node. This is a kind of parity will be created. it will be synced together and get the information between these two only. While store the data, here 1 GB actual data is going to be stored, and it should know what kind of parity will be created with other nodes. Okay, based on the blocks only, parity block, not a node. Okay, 1 GB of data will be split into eight partitions. Okay, this 8 blocks will create the parity, right? This parity will be communicated here as well as here, and compress and store it. It will not be stored the same 1 GB of raw data with other data nodes. You just try to compress. So 1 GB will be, while you are trying to compress it, it will be converted to 400 MB maximum. This 400 MB will be split four blocks partitions here and four partitions here as well. Whenever data node 1 goes down, this data immediately unzip and store into data nodes. Okay, this kind of operation, they are following it. Just mechanism same, but they are trying to store the data with the zipped format here. And whenever they have to pause the query, it will be unzipped and store it. This is only happening. Okay, are you clear with the parity block? Say yes or no.
Can you repeat again?
That's the reason I just called, but okay. I will do one thing. Okay. Let me clear this things first.
Dinesh, can you compare 2x and 3x while saying?
After this replication and then only we can compare it.
Okay.
I will go in step by step. Okay, this is the data node 1. You know very well, 1 GB of data name node come receive the request, try to store the 1 GB of TXT file in data node 1 itself. And the data node 1 GB of file have four partitions, eight partitions data is available here. What it is going to do, this 8 blocks will be split and stored into other nodes. It just decided and store 2, 4, 2. Okay, such kind of different partitions they have decided and trying to store it. We have only 2 nodes. Okay, let me reduce it. Okay, so 4, 4. Now for the differentials, 5, 3. Okay, so total 8 block. Data node 1 have a parity with the data node 2 as well as the 3, it will be create the parities. So 5 and 3. Here the parity space will be created. Okay. So data node 5, right? Sorry, data node 1, 5 blocks of data, right? This is first will be stored into data node 3 in parity path. And 3 block size of partition is trying to store into a data node. This is compressed data, not 1 GB will not be transferred to other data node. It just zip and convert into 400 MB. 400 MB, if you compare with 5 and 3 material, it will 220 and 80, I think so. So 220 MB of data will be stored in data node 2, and 80 MB of data will be stored into, 120 MB of data will be stored into data node 3. It's a compressed data. Whenever data node 1 goes down, at the time only here the zip, for example, I'm saying as a zip, it will not be a zip format. It is uncompressed and stored into your data node too. Okay, and then it will be continuing the business. So in this case, your data actual is 1 GB and compressed data only for 400 MB across all your replications. So maximum 1.4 GB spaces only you are going to use it instead of 3 GB of spaces. This is the difference. Hadoop 2x into 3x direct replication you're trying to do so that the data will be stored 3 GB spaces. 1 GB of data into 2x replication, total 3x will happen. Here, 400 MB only. 1.4 GB of data only will be used across all your node. This is the comparison between Hadoop 2x and 3x. This is the first step. Let me complete replications and all, and I will do the comparison between Hadoop 2x and 3x in detail. Okay. Till now, any question about parity block?
Dinesh, a quick question. The beta node 1, does it have the 1 GB plus the zipped version of it, or just the 1 GB? And the data node 2 and 3 will have the zipped.
Data node 2 and 3 only have the zip file, the compressed data.
Okay. Sure.
Because it will not be stored the same place, right? That's the concept intra-data node. It will not. Mm-hmm. Okay. Because actual data it will be stored. I'm giving the example for 1 GB, it will be stored directly here. Because you will not be confused. Based on the partition, 2 partition will be stored in data node 1, 2 partition stored in data node 2, and 4 partition will be stored in data node 3. Particular data only will be compressed and split with your parity blocks.
Okay.
Okay. For comparison, I just take the same data with the whole single node itself.
Thank you.
Okay. Any other question? Okay, fine. Then I will tell you what this XR algorithm is doing as well as RS code. RS code is a kind of your data accuracy. It's a kind of compression you are trying to do that, right? The data compression serialization, whether it's properly synced or not. This kind of coding mechanism will be handled with your RS code algorithm. Before coming to Hadoop concept, you can see this RS code concept with your CD DVDs. If any small crack is happening in your CD DVD, it will not be running properly while you're going to playing it. Because based on the RS code algorithm only, it will be monitored. Okay, it keep on monitor all your data. Any, I cannot explain with verbal. Let me go with some Google. This is a part of engineering. Whoever has completed the engineering, they know about it. This code, read Solomon code. Mostly they are giving us an algorithm here. Okay, it's not that one. Mm-hmm. Okay, let me take this one because this is a very easy look like. It will take more time. It works a very small size. Okay, let me copy this. image and clear it. Okay, you can see this one. RS coding only just trying to read the data and convert it. While you're going to play the VCD or DVD, it's just going to be get the data, it's just encoded. You're going to play with TV, right? Example, I'm saying. The data will be MPEG format, it's just encoded, and RS coding only going to be validated. All the data properly sync and store it or not, something like that. If any small crack has happened, you cannot play the video. You have to forward, go forward, and then only you can play it. This kind of crack, anything has happened while zip your data, that will be monitored by this RS code. That's it. Simple understand. Sorry, it's a detailed information, but I'm trying to summarize and give you. Because while you are going to zip your data, right? At the time, it should be properly compressed. Even a single mistake has happened, it will be retried to compress it. Because we have only 1x replication data properly available. All other is compressed and stored in parity block, as we discussed before. So this RS code algorithm only will be taking the responsibility and serialize all the data and monitor. If any noise or error data comes, then it will not be allowed to compress your data. Because 1GB file is going to store with the 400 MB. So maybe have chances to corrupt it. This algorithm helped to avoid this kind of corruptions. This corrupt concept is called as a noise. In this algorithm, they are calling as a noise. But as per our understanding, the zipping format will be considered as a corrupted records. Are you trying to understand?
Yes, finish.
Because it's a huge algorithm concept, we cannot explain in a single manner. But this is the concept. Because you have a proper data, if you are not properly compressed and stored into your parity block, then while you are trying to uncompress it, then the data will be corrupted. You cannot handle your data. Since you have only 1 GB of data, and that particular 1 GB of data is going down, then only you can uncompress your data. So there you have a trouble. So this RS code only helps to monitor and clear the noises, and proper compression will happen with the help of this other. Okay, nothing beyond it. Otherwise, we have to take some data and we will see with 0 and 1 how it is converted. Everything we have to discuss. We don't want to go in detail. It will take 2 hours more. But this is enough because nobody will ask about RS code in interview as well. For your reference, I'm trying to. Okay, so now based on the RS code, XR gateway is going to work. XR gateway is nothing but 0, 1 will be followed, right? XR algorithm only here. So XR truth table, nothing behind it. If any one place is replicated, then it will be considered as a true flag. Okay, based on the data will be paired with other blocks. Otherwise, it will be replicated to all other blocks. So XR gateway keep on monitoring and will give you no places to replicate same data into two parity block. So it will be always the last option will not coming here. Data is not available, that should be a 0. Any one of the place will be replicated, then it will be considered as a true flag. This is happening. Okay. Based on RS code, XR, as well as your parity block concept, the replication will successfully handle with your Hadoop 3x. Also, they have some checkpoints. This algorithm is only work with rack-based servers. Okay, some rack server where are you going to use it? There only it will be work. Even though that's specific, some rack server they suggested. Okay, so that's the reason most of the company will not be moved entirely with Hadoop 3x still, because this kind of hardware configuration also they will be suggested prerequisites. So overall is going to newly migrate with Hadoop platform. They are trying to move directly with Hadoop 3x. But overall is existing, they will not be moved into Hadoop 3x. Due to this kind of hardware prerequisites. But in future, 4x, they will come with a new feature solution, then definitely everyone will move it. Okay? Are you clear? Any question, application? Any question? They say yes or no, or not understand. Even not understand, I'm fine.
I think we're okay.
You will be recall the sessions, recordings, and all, then you'll get more detail. If still you're not clear, then you just inform me, we will discuss in detail. But separate session.
Sir, XR gate algorithm, can you explain once again? RS code clearly understood. Based on CD example you told us, so suppose.
Okay, so simple, data node 1, data node 2, you can consider 1 and 2 only here. Okay, simple. You're trying to store the data, right? 1 GB of data, you're going to store it. So it needs to store with the other parity. So data node 1 parity with data node 2 as well as data node 3. While trying to replicate data, and this data will be properly unzipped and it will be stored into data node 1. Sorry, data node 2. Here the data will be available. Here, which means it's a 0, sorry, it's a 1. Other nodes as a 0. XR gateway 1 and 0 always it will be providing. We have seen, right? 0, 1 or 1, 0. It will be a truth. True, true. So data properly replicated. This thing only is monitored. Okay.
So if in one of the places, if it is set up properly, it will say true.
Yeah, data sync properly, that's it. Okay, 1 GB, I just mentioned as a direct 1 GB of single file. 1 GB have 5, 8 partitions. So 4 partitions, right? So 4 partition, 4 plus 4. So 2 partitions. So data node 2 have this 4 partitions of parity data. Data node 3 have 4 partitions of this parity of data. Then again, each parity is going to be checked with that particular block only. That's the reason, that is the meaning for parity block. So block 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So parity block, data node 1, 2, data node 3. Here nothing, here available. Here available, here nothing, here available. So here nothing, here available, here nothing, here available. Everything is a true, then only the data will be properly synced and paired. This kind of truth operation will be handled by your XR gate. This algorithm will be monitored. Okay?
So zero means that the data has not actually gone properly there in data node 3, right?
No, it will not be replicated here. These are all, I will show you this block address. Tomorrow we are going to discuss, right? At the time, I will show you how we can see the block address. And that I will show you details. Let me try, wait.
Sir, I have another one doubt. Can you show that image?
Yeah.
What our things?
Yeah, I will. Okay, tell me, what is your doubt?
Sir, suppose I am trying to load 2 GB data.
Okay.
First file 1 GB data.
Mm.
Second file 1 GB data.
Okay.
Totally 2 GB.
Mm.
After loading, it is split into 3, 3.
Okay.
Sorry, 2, 2, 2, 3. So it got splitted.
Okay, whatever the
first file only. Okay. First file only got corrupted. Some
while loading the data or replicating the data, it just corrupted. There is two ways of happening, right? While loading the data itself, it just
corrupted. Not loading. While replicating.
While replicating, it just corrupted. Then RS code will not allow to replicate it because it will be finding the noise errors, right? So it will not be allowed to replicate the data. It will be delete and re-replicate to that particular node.
I am not asking about while replicating or while loading. After storing into Hadoop ecosystem, one data node got corrupted.
Okay, one node itself, it just failed. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Certainly. You are trying to store the data.
Yeah.
Name node will be receiving this information and try to store the data. Data node one is trying to store here, right?
Okay.
While storing the data, this blocks will be split into, let's take 2 GB of data as you advise. This data have almost, for example, 10 partitions of record. Blocks will be going to log. Okay. So 10 block is going to be log, then only the 2 GB of data will be stored. Example, I'm saying.
Okay.
While storing the data, the block will be properly synced and stored, right? This data will be synced with the data nodes. Each block will be have parity and trying to store it here.
Okay.
Okay. This data properly sent all the nodes, the replication is properly done, then only the task is completed. Otherwise, the replication is not completed. Okay, that is happening in the backend.
Okay.
In case, as you advised, you are trying to store the data node one itself, and it is having some trouble to delete, your node goes down or something fault has happened with your data node itself, name node can design and provide that particular task to other nodes. It will not be wait for data node one itself. Name node can take the decision and provide to other data nodes. Okay. Because it should be stored in other platform. This node goes down. Okay, fine. We have alternate. They are directly trying to store it there. Okay.
Okay. I have another doubt related to this.
Mm.
After unzipping the data, it will validate or?
While storing the data, as well as.
After storing.
While it stores the data, right? Because it's a blocks only, each block will be replicated. Okay. 1 GB of data you're trying to store. Okay. One block completely done, then it will start the replications. Okay. It will not be wait for it until 1 GB is stored. Based on the blocks only, try to replicate it. That is the reason it's a parity block.
Okay.
Block. Based on the block only, it's just parity.
Okay. The RS code and XR code based on parity block only, it will work.
Yeah. Based on the block only, everything will be handled.
Okay.
Even mapper also following the block. Okay.
Okay.
This input split is a part of blocks only, block size only. Any other question?
Dinesh, trying to recollect, consider if you're going to store 1 GB or 100 GB to name node. So, how many subnodes the data will be? If it is a HDFS 2X, so node one will have complete 1 GB and also we'll have a copy on other two nodes, data nodes, right? Is that right?
Yeah, it should be replicated. We will not be discussing HDFS 2x and 3x. Tomorrow we will go with 2x and 3x comparison, don't worry.
Okay.
Only we just discuss about replication. As we advise, 100 GB of data, you're trying to store it here. This 100 GB, 20 here, 30 here, 40 here, 2, 3, 4. 5 years, something like it will be replicated. The data will be split, the partition will be split and stored. How the data replicated in 2x and 3x? This is we are discussing now. In Hadoop 2x, by default 2x replication, the same data, actual data will be replicated to other node. And Hadoop 3x just compressed and stored with the parity block concept. This is only we discussed. Tomorrow session, we just go in detail with the other
thing. All data, all data nodes, it's not going to carry those 100 full GB.
Sorry. Yeah, 100 GB will be split randomly and store it across all your data nodes.
And
it will be stored in the same data node itself.
Okay, 100 GB will be split and stored in data nodes, and this replication concept differs between 2x and 3x.
How the replication they will be followed into x by 3x format. It should be replicated. 100 GB should be stored as a 300 GB in Hadoop 2x version. But 100 GB data will be stored 140 GB only in your Hadoop 3 expression. That's the difference. Okay. Getting my point.
Can you write that anywhere on the screen for?
Simple. 100 GB data you are trying to write into SDFS 2x. 2x replications in SDFS 2, right? Then 300 GB you are going to spend. But in Hadoop 3x versions, it will be stored only with 140 GB maximum. 142, 150, 160 GB maximum, because compressed data will be reduced to compare with your normal data. Those compressed data will be split and stored with your parent. So maximum 140 GB will be stored. Almost maximum 160 maximum, I'm saying. Depends on your size of your node, size of your files. If it is a normal compressed text file or other, then it will be highly compressed and go with 40 GB only maximum. If you're going to use Pocket, OOS, this kind of files, it will not be allowed that much compression. So 60 GB up to it will be expanded.
In 2x, there is no compression at all, right?
Yeah. Okay. And whatever the data, actual data will be replicated.
Okay. In 3x, whether at least in one node, there will be no compression and other two nodes will be have the partial compressed data.
Yes.
Okay.
We have a actual sustained data one copy and compressed data as a backup copy. Once node goes down, that particular data node uncompress and store the actual data to us, and it will be created another one parity with other data nodes. Parities are available. It will be keep on monitor and created. Okay. All the actual one data node, that's it. One node. Yeah.
All those operations are internally happens, or whether we have to force the system to do this partitioning?
No, it this is concept, as I said, right? Intra data node concept will be taking the backend.
Okay.
Okay.
Thanks.
Okay. Any question? Otherwise, let me summarize today's sessions, because we have discussed a little more detail. You may be confused in some place. So, any question till now, whatever we have discussed?
Dinesh, is this the first class or?
This is the first session.
Okay.
Today, just to start, what is Hadoop? Okay. Last session, we just discussed what we are going to study and how the environment looks like. That's it. Just a discussion. Okay, this is the actual session.
Okay, for installation, what are the prerequisites required for a laptop?
Later I will tell you, because a few people is not confirmed it, right? Again, I don't like to wasting that time also. Everyone is confirmed, we will go with the installation pattern.
Okay, I am having Windows 8.1 for a...
That's not a problem. Only you want to install the Docker, based on your cores and RAM, that cluster size will be modified.
Is it enough 8 GB RAM?
I think so.
Okay.
So it's not big deal based on your cluster decision, right? Your system, right? Based on that, our container is going back. I have created different size of image of containers. So don't worry.
Okay.
Also, we have separate VM, don't worry. Okay. Private virtual memory, virtual VM we have. Okay. So that is also, we can use it.
Okay,
fine. Let me come to summarized what we have discussed today. What is Hadoop? As well as what are the layers is available, what is the difference between storage layer and processing layer, and then what are the Hadoop architecture, what are the daemons is available, how daemons will help for the Hadoop framework development, and inside the Hadoop, what is name node, data node, how it will be communicated together, and what is secondary name node, and what is the SPNN, checkpoint, backup, what is YARN, and we have seen some example with the YARN, how the job will be submitted, how the job will be communicated with the resource manager and node manager, while we are going to run some command, how the state will be modified, the resource allocations, everything we have seen just before with some examples. As well as, we just discussed the replication factors, the difference between 2x and 3x versions of Hadoop, and default replication, errors or encoding concept, inside the errors or encoding, RS code, XR gateway, parity block, these are all things we just discussed today. We didn't go in detail. This is the basics we just discussed. Okay, So tomorrow we just go with the block size, input speed, block report. These are some other things is available. Like we go in detail how it is happening. And then we plan to discuss with some Hadoop basic commands and a comparison with Linux. Those who are not good with Hadoop, sorry, Linux platform, they need to know how Linux is working. So we have to do some comparison and then we can go with Hadoop commands as well. Okay, this is the tomorrow's agenda. Okay, any questions? And finally, we are going to discuss Hadoop 2x and 3x, the complete difference. 1x, 2x, 3x, all three we can do. Okay.
One more doubt about the class timings.
Yeah. 6 to 8 only down.
6 to 8 only.
Yeah.
Up to end.
Yeah.
Okay.
We don't have other time.
Okay. Okay.
So that's I just confirmed before, right? Okay.
Now okay.
Okay, let me stop recording then.
Can you please share the video for reference? Suppose one more time.
Wait.